Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see a numerical on the design of the gusseted base. So let's start. Now in the design problem, the statement says a column of ISHB 350 mm depth at 661.2 Newton per meter strength carries an axial compressive factored load. So you have been given directly the factored load of 1700 kN. Design a suitable bolted gusset base. So connection may be either through the bolts or through the welding. But in this question, this has been said that the connection is bolted one. The base rests on M15 grade of concrete pedestal. Use 24 mm diameter bolts of grade 4.6 for making the connections. So first of all, we'll write all the data that has been given to us. So data that has been given is the corresponding to Indian standard heavy beam of 350 mm depth. So from here, we will use the Indian standard handbook number 1 to filter out the data corresponding to this I section. The properties of ISHB 350 from the Indian Standard Handbook that we get is that depth of the section is 350 millimeters. So the depth of this section has been given as 350 millimeter. So these properties of Indian Standard Handbook number 1 are taken directly. So there are number of properties which are corresponding to different I section or different fillet angles. So all those properties are directly taken from the handbook. So depth of the section has been given as 350 millimeter. Width of the flange, that is denoted by BF, that is given as 250 millimeter. Similarly, the thickness of the flange, that has been given as 11.6 millimeter, and the thickness of the web, that has been given as 8.3 millimeter.
So this is the data which will be useful to us.
The grade of steel, it is never given in the problem, then that has to be taken as 410 megapascals. Therefore, the ultimate strength for the steel will be 410 newton per square millimeter, and corresponding to it, the yield strength for the steel will be 250 newton per square millimeter. So from here we are getting these two datas. Now as for the first step, we need to find out the bearing strength of the concrete. So the bearing strength of concrete is given by the formula that is taken as 0.45 fck, while the codal provision says that the bearing strength must be of 0.6 fck, that is as per the Indian standard 800-2007 edition. So from here the grade of concrete has been given as the M15, so from here FCK will be 15, so we will get the bearing strength of the concrete as 6.75 Newton per square millimeter. So bearing strength of concrete is obtained as 6.75 Newton per square millimeter. Now as per the second step, we need to find out the area which will be suitable for obtaining or assuming this much amount of bearing pressure. So the step 2 of the design process says that the area of base plate, that is the area which will be required to safely transfer the load with this much amount of bearing intensity. So it will be equal to the load divided by bearing pressure. The load that has been given, and the load is the factored one. Factored axial compressive load is given as 1700 kN. So it will be 1700 newton into 10 raised to the power 3 newton, and the bearing pressure that was obtained, that was 6.75 newton per square millimeter. So from here the value of area that we are getting, that comes out to be 251.85 into 10 raised to the power 3 square millimeter. So this is the area which will be obtained or that will be required for safely transmitting the load of 1700 kN with a bearing intensity of 6.75 Newton per square millimeter. Now in the step 3, we will design the gusset base. So for designing that gusset base, in case of gusseted base, we assume the thickness of the gusseted base first. So I've told you that, as we have seen in the theory portion, that for gusseted base, its thickness, the plate thickness, should never be less than 16 mm. So let's assume a thickness of 16 mm for the gusset plate. So this gusset plate thickness of 16 mm is assumed, and I'm showing it here. So this is your column section. It is ISHB 350. Then these are the gusset plates. These are the gusset plates, and these are the gusset angle on both the sides. Okay, these are the gusset angle. These gusset angles are provided for making the connection smooth. Whenever we are providing the bolted connection, it is a must. While in case of welded joints, it may be provided or may not be. So, whenever we are providing the bolts, let's say we will be providing the bolts in this manner only, that we will be connecting the angles, gusset plates and the column, all three of them, by the bolts. Similarly, the gusset angle and the gusseted base, these will be connected in the downward direction. And this is your gusset base, which is shown with the orange color. So now, assuming the thickness of the gusset plate of 16 mm and a suitable gusset angle is also to be assumed. So we will take a gusset angle of similar thickness. So a gusset angle of 150 by 115 by 15 mm, because thickness of this is to be kept near about this thickness. So that's why we have chosen this type of angle section of 150 mm by 115 mm by 15 mm size. So this has been our assumption. So from here we know that if we project this upper diagram on the plan section, so we will get a drawing similar to this manner, that this I section will be looking like an I. Then there are these gusset plates on both the sides. These are our gusset plates and the angle. So angle that we will be seeing from the top, this will be looking like this on both the sides. This will be our angle section. So the length of the gusseted base plate that will be required, so minimum length required to accommodate this assembly, so minimum length required that will be equal to this thickness, first this thickness of the column, and this has been given directly from the Indian Standard Handbook number 1, that is 350 mm, plus the thickness of the gusseted plates on both the sides. So that will be 2 into 16 millimeters, because we have assumed a gusseted plate of thickness 16 millimeters. Plus, now we are having the thickness of the angle. So the angle length are given as 150 by 115. So that means this is an unequal angle. So this type of angle section, these are known as the unequal angle. So this will be our angle section which will be provided. So one side is 150 mm and other one is 115. While the thickness of the angle section throughout the section, it is 15 mm. So out of these two sides, out of 150 and 115, we usually take the longer side with the flange of the column, so that a better connection or the better connection length can be provided. And the lesser value of the angle section is taken on the gusseted base. So now when you are looking at the plan section, so this leg that will be resting, so when you will be seeing this angle from the top, the length that you will be seeing, that will be 115. So now adding 2 into 115 on both the sides, we will get the minimum length that will be required to accommodate this assembly. So this value, when we calculate this one, that comes out to be 612 millimeters. So that means this is the minimum length which will be required. Although we will provide the length of the gusseted base more than this one, so length provided will be slightly larger than this value. So let's say we are providing the length equal to 620 millimeters, so that we can have few overhang on both the sides, a smaller value of overhang on both the sides. So overhang provided, what will be that value? So overhang will be the length which has been actually provided, that is 620, minus the length which was required, that is 612, divided by 2, because overhang is provided on both the sides. So from here we get this value as 4 mm. So that means this overhang portion, this is 4 mm on both the sides. Now since we have calculated the length which will be provided, so now dividing the required area by the length which has been provided, we will get the width of the base plate which will be required
or which will be provided directly.
Now width of the plate which will be required, so width required, that will be area divided by length which has been provided. So area was obtained as 251.85 into 10 raised to the power 3 square millimeter, while the length that we have provided, that is 620 mm. So from here we will get the value of the width of the base plate that will be required. So that comes out to be 406.2 mm and which is roughly taken as 410 mm. So that means we will provide a gusset base of what dimension? We will provide the gusset base of 620 by 410 mm below the column and above the concrete pedestal. Now the next step, that is step number 4, that will be regarding the connections. Now step number 4 is regarding the gusseted base that we have designed. So we have found out the size of the gusseted base. So whenever we are designing any base plate, we are concerned with the two parameters. First one is the size of the gusseted base and the other one is the thickness of the gusseted base. So size of the gusseted base or any base plate that has been found in the first step, in the previous step, that has been of 620 mm by 410 mm. Now we need to find out the thickness of the gusseted base that is to be provided. So for that, first of all, we will need to calculate the actual bearing intensity that is occurring on the gusseted base. So actual bearing pressure is calculated by the load divided by actual area or the area that has been provided. And for that, we need to take the actual values of the length and the width. So the actual area was, this will be 1700 into 10 raised to the power 3, that is your the given load, factored load divided by the area. So it will be 620 divided by 410. So from here we will get the actual bearing pressure that will be acting on the gusseted base. So this value comes out to be 6.68 Newton per square millimeter, which is less than the actual value that was taken as 0.45 FCK, and that was coming out to be 6.75. So that means it is okay, while the limiting value is further greater than this one. That means if it is lesser than this value, then it will also be less than 0.6 FCK. Now in the next step, that is step 5, we will try to calculate the thickness of the gusseted base. So for the thickness of the gusseted base, I've told you that we need to find out the overhang portion, because the calculation is done corresponding to overhang portion. So that means if I again draw the diagram, so this was the column and then the gusseted plates were provided, and after that one gusset angle on each side was provided.
This was the assembly.
Okay, and this was the load which was acting on the column, and further from column it was transferred to the base plate. Now this overhang portion, which was calculated as C1 and it was obtained as 4 mm. So this will be the bearing pressure which will be acting on it, and this actual bearing pressure was 6.68. Now in case of the gusseted base, the critical section for calculation of the moment is taken as the root of the fillet weld. Okay, it is taken as the root of the fillet of the angle. Okay, at this portion, this critical section is taken, while in the case of slab bases, it was taken at the face of the column. This was in the case of slab base, while in the case of gusseted base, this is the critical section. In the case of gusseted base, this is the critical section. So now calculating the moment at the critical section. So the moment at critical section that will be equal to the bearing pressure intensity. So this overhang portion is 4 millimeter. Now if we take a look at the angle section, so this was the angle section, so I'm drawing it in the clear manner so that you will be able to calculate the actual length which will be required. So this was the angle section, while the base plate below it was in this direction of this much length. Let's say we are not taking the rest of the part. So this overhang was 4 millimeter, while this length, this was 115 millimeter, because in actual we have provided the longer leg on the column flange that we have already seen. So that means from the critical section, this is the critical section, this length which we calculated as C1, this will be 115 up to this point plus 4 mm. So it will be 115 plus 4 millimeter. This will be the entire length minus, we need to subtract this value. We need to subtract this value. So this value is the thickness of the angle section, and the thickness of the angle section is 15 millimeter. So from here we get the value of C1 as 104 millimeters. So this is the value of the C1. So movement at the critical section is calculated as W into C1 divided by 2. So from here we get the equation as WC1 square divided by 2. Now putting the values of the actual bearing intensity, that is 6.68, and C1 value as 104 millimeter, we will get the movement at the critical section. So that is calculated as, so the movement at the critical section, that is calculated as 6.68 into 104 square divided by 2. That is, putting all the values, we get this value as 36125.4, that is Newton millimeter. So this is the value of the critical moment that will be obtained. Now we need to find out the bearing capacity or the moment capacity. It would be rather correct that it is the moment capacity of the plate that will be bearing this much amount of moment. So moment capacity of the base plate, that will be calculated by the formula that we have already seen, that is 1.2 Fy into Ze. And since we are taking the limit state case, so we will be dividing it with the partial factor of safety. Now from here we have seen that if we are taking the unit thickness, so this Ze can be written as BD square divided by 6, where this B value is assumed to be of unit width, while this depth of this section is taken equal to the thickness of the gusseted base or thickness of the base plate. Now to resist the movement, we are having this much value of the thickness with us, that is, first one is this base plate and then the angle section. So this is the assembly. Now when we are talking about the assembly, in that case we are having this much thickness which will be contributing to the resistance of the movement. So now when we are resisting the movement, we are taking the thickness of the gusseted base as well as the thickness of the angle. So from here the thickness that we will be getting, this will be the combined thickness, and from that we need to subtract the thickness of the angle to calculate the thickness of the gusseted base. So now first placing all the values in this equation, 1.2, now this value of the yield stress that was taken as 250 MPa or 250 Newton per square millimeter into Z value is 1 into T square divided by 6, and this gamma m naught, this is taken to be 1.1 of the material. Now from here the value that we get, it is 45.45 T square. Now equating, let's say we have taken this value as the 1 and this is second. Now equating these two equation, so equation 1, that means the critical moment, if our plate is able to carry this much amount of movement, that means it will be safe, because that will be the critical value, that will be the maximum value which will be obtained on the base plate. So equation 1 and 2, by equating those two values, we get the T value, and let's say this will be equal to 36125.44 divided by 45.45 and its square root. So from here the thickness of the total assembly that we will be getting, that is coming out to be 28.19 millimeter. Now since this is the thickness of the total, so that's why the thickness of the gusseted base, let's say we are representing that with the value of Tg, so it will be equal to T minus Ta, that is the thickness of the angle. So it is 28.19 minus the thickness of the angle that was assumed to be of 15 millimeter size, because it is the standard size of the angle section and that we have taken as 150 by 115 multiplied by 15. So this is the angle section that we have obtained, that is Indian standard angle. So from here the value that we are getting, it is 13.19 millimeter. Now the size of the gusseted base that we have obtained is 13.19 millimeter, while the size that we have taken, that was 16 millimeter. So that is correct. And the check says that the thickness of the gusseted base or the base plate, it should always be greater than the thickness of the flange of the column. That is the thickness of the flange of the column. So the thickness of the gusseted base, it should be greater than this value. And from the values that we have obtained, that is 13.9 millimeter, that has been done as per the calculation, while the thickness of the flange has been obtained as 11.6 millimeter. So that means it is okay. So our design process is okay. So therefore we will provide a base plate, of size 620 millimeter by 410 millimeter multiplied by 16 millimeter in size. So provide a base plate of 620 by 410 by 16 millimeter in size. So that is the complete design of the gusseted base. Now in the question it has been said that we need to design the connection also. So you can see that we need to design a suitable bolted gusseted base. So that means we need to design for the bolts as well. So step number 6, it says, so step number 6 is for the bolted connection. So for bolted connections, first of all we need to write down the data that has been given to us. So diameter of the bolt that is given to us, that will be 24 millimeter. And as we know that whenever we provide a bolt, let's say its diameter was 24 millimeter, but corresponding to it the hole which will be done in the plate, that will be bigger than this. So that is known as the diameter of the hole, which is represented by D naught. So for values greater than 16 millimeter of the diameter, we take this value, additional value, as plus 2. So from here the diameter of the hole that we will be getting, that is 26 millimeter. Diameter of the hole that we are getting, that is 26 millimeters. Now the net bolt area that we are calculating, that is calculated as per the formula 0.78 pi by 4 d square. So from here the value that we are getting, that is coming out to be 353 square millimeter. Now the value of the pitch, is the distance between the center to center of the bolts along the direction of the force. So let's say if this is one plate and this is acted upon by the force in this direction, so the distance between center to center of the bolts, that will be taken as the pitch value. Now this is taken as 2.5 times the D and that comes out to be 60 millimeter. Now the distance of the plate edges from the last present bolt, that is known as the edge distance. So these are all the parameters which will be required to us for the calculation. So this E value is taken as 1.5 times of the D naught. So that comes out to be 39 millimeter. And the gamma MB value, that is the partial safety factor for the bolts, that is taken to be 1.25 millimeter. Now this is all the data that will be required for the designing of the bolted connection. Now as I've already told you, now looking back again at the diagram, so this diagram shows that these are the volts which will be provided for the connection. Now, at the interface of the every connection, that means at the interface of the column and the gusseted plates, at the interface of the gusset plates and the gusset angles, the volts are in single shear. That means if we again draw the diagram, then we can analyze that the every interface, let's say this was the gusseted plate and this is the angle. Now the volt which will be providing the connection, this is subjected to this single shear. That means only one line of force will be passing through it. So the volts are in single shear, because for single shear and double shear, for formulas for designing of the bolts, both are different. So whenever the bolts are in single shear and bearing, we need to calculate the strength as per that value only. So this VSB, that is the bolt strength in single shear, that is taken to be the net area for the bolt into the ultimate strength of the bolt divided by root 3, which is taken as the designing factor, divided by the partial safety factor for the bolt. Now this ANB, that is the net area of the bolt that we have calculated, that comes out to be 353 into this ultimate strength for the bolt, because the bolt grade generally is of 4.6, where this 4 represents the ultimate strength. So this is 4 into 100, which tells us about the ultimate strength, while the yielding strength is calculated by 4 into 6, that is 24, and that is represented by 10, that is 240. Because since we are here dealing with the ultimate strength, so it will be taken as 400 divided by root 3 divided by gamma MB, that is taken to be 1.25. So from here, the bolts in single shear will be subjected to a force of 65.21 kN. So that means these bolts are sufficient to carry this much amount of load in the shear. While in case of, so this was the case of shear. Now in case of bearing, for the bearing parameter, we design it as the VPB. So this value is taken at 2.5 kb into d, that is the diameter of the bolt, into the thickness into fu divided by gamma mb, where this kb is one constant that we'll be calculating, d is the diameter of the bolt, t is the thickness of the thinner member. If we are providing a connection that was between the gusset angle and the gusseted plate, so out of these two, which one will be having the lesser thickness, that will be provided as the value of the t, and fu that we have already seen, that is the ultimate strength for the bolt. Now this kb value, this is the minimum of four values. So it is minimum of e by 3d naught, that is the edge distance divided by 3 into diameter of the bolt, that will be simply represented by d, divided by p by 3d, that is the pitch distance divided by 3 into diameter of the bolt, and the other values are represented by the ultimate strength of the bolt divided by the ultimate strength of the plate. This fu simply represents the ultimate strength of the plate. So from here, and last value is 1.0. These are the four values which will be taken for the calculation of this kb value. All the values are known to us. This fub, that was 400, while this fu, that is for plate, that is 410. Now all the values we are having. So from here, if we calculate the value of the kb, the minimum of all the four values, that comes out to be 0.541, and that is corresponding to e by 3d naught, that is corresponding to this e by 3d. So e was as 39, 3 into diameter of the bolt was 24. So from here, if we do the calculation, we get the value as 0.541. So that means that is the smallest value out of these four values. So now putting all the values in the equation, that we will be having VPB, that is the main strength of the bolt in the bearing, that is 2.5 into 0.541 into this KB value is, that is 0.541, diameter of the bolt, that is 24. Now the thickness of the thinner member, since we are having three places here, at the end of this we were having the column section. So the thickness of this flange was also connected with the gusset plate. So out of these three, the thickness of the flange was 11.6, thickness of the gusset plate was 16, while the thickness of the angle was 15. Out of these three, the minimum value is 11.6. And I've already told you that the thickness of the thinner member is to be taken. So that is 11.6 into the ultimate strength of the plate, that is 410, divided by the factor of safety for the bolt, that is 1.25. So from here, the value that we are getting, that comes out to be 124.64 kN. Now the bolt value, that is the actual value of the strength that will be taken, or that will be the capacity of the bolt that is taken to be the minimum of the shear and the bearing factors. So out of these two, as we can see, the value of 65.21 is lesser. So therefore, the bolt value is taken to be the minimum of VSB and VPB. So this will be equal to 65.21 kN. Now once we have got this value of the bolt value, now we will directly divide it or use it to calculate the number of bolts required to carry out the safe transfer of the load. So now in the case of the designing of the bolts, whenever we assume that the ends of the sections are completely machined, that means this was the column section. Now if this is the end of the column section and this is the base plate, now whenever we are providing any connection between these two, let's say this is the connection. Now if these ends are properly machined, that means they can completely overlay over each other, that means there will be a complete machining or complete bearing action. While if the ends are machined, and in the second case, if the ends are not machined, then if we are connecting the ends, that means there will not be a proper connection between the two. So that means the transfer of the force will not be a smoother. So that's why we assume a machined bearing, because whenever the project is of utmost importance, we usually prefer the machined bearing. Because in machined bearing, what happens? 50% load is transferred. 50% load transfer through the bearing action, while the rest of the 50% and 50% transfer through the connection. So that means the connection that we are providing, in this case we are providing the bolted connection, so the bolt connection will be transmitting the 50% of the load. So the bolted connection will be transmitting the 50% of the load. So the number of bolts which will be required to transmit the 50% of the load, so 50% of 1700 is to be transmitted, and each bolt can transmit a value of 65.21, because all the units are in kilonewton, so that's why I'm not writing about the units. So 0.5 of 1700, that comes out to be 850 divided by 65.21. So from here, the value of the bolt that we are getting, number of bolts, that comes out to be 13.03. So since that is not a even number, so because this is the total number of bolts which will be provided in the entire assembly, but since we are concerned about the both the plates, so we will provide a larger number than this. So that means we are providing 16 number of bolts. We will provide 16 number of bolts so that we can maintain the symmetry of the bolted connection. Now what is the meaning of this symmetry? So let's say I'm showing you the other diagram. This is the column flange. If we are looking at the side of the plate, so this was the gusseted plate. Now this gusseted plate was having this thickness at the top, and at the bottom this is the portion which will be supported by the angle section. Now this is the angle section of 15 millimeter thickness. Now when we are providing this column is extended up to the bottom, Now, whenever we are providing the connection, we will connect the gusseted plate as well as the gusset angle and the column flange. Now, the number of bolts that we are providing, that is 16. So, 8 number of bolts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, 8. These are provided to connect the column flange, gusset plate and the gusseted angle. While the rest of the portion is taken to connect the gusseted plate to the gusset angle. So, the gusset plate and gusset angle, those must be having the similar number of bolts. That's we have provided 16 number of bolts. So that if you calculate the number of bolts in the flange and the gusseted plate, that comes out to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And similarly, in the gusseted plate and the gusseted angle, that is coming out to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again, this value is coming out to be 8. So, if we calculate this thickness or the height of the gusseted plate, that what size of gusset plate is to be provided, because we have now, till now, have calculated the size of the gusseted base and the width of the gusseted base. So till now, we have provided the connection between the plate and the column flange and the angle. Now, since we know that this entire width is of the gusseted base, so that's why this gusseted base width will be 410 millimeter, and that will be the width of the gusset plate also. This is our gusset plate, while this is the gusset angle. Now the height of the gusset plate is to be calculated. Now for the calculation of the height of the gusset plate, what we need, that this is the portion of the angle that is of 150 millimeter that is already with us. So this height of the gusset plate will be this height of the angle section, that is 150 millimeter, plus the thickness of this pitch, that is 1 into 60, that is pitch length, plus twice the value of the edge distances, that is from the edges of the plate to the bolt. So from here we will get the actual value or actual height of the base plate, that is of 280 millimeter. So this is the height of the gusset plate that is to be provided, and the length of the gusset plate, that will be the entire length of the base plate, that is 410 millimeter. So that's why we will provide a gusset plate of size, its size will be 410 millimeter, that is the length, the height is 288 into 16 millimeter in size. So we will provide a gusset plate of 410 by 288 into 16 millimeter in size. Now the last part of this connection is the for the checking part. So providing some check on the values that we have obtained. So we need to calculate the outstand value. So once again drawing the diagram. So this is our column section which is transmitting the load to the base plate with the help of the gusset plate. Now this is the, let's say this is the gusset plate that is to be provided. Now this gusset plate is this much in the size, and at the top it is becoming equal to the width of the flange. So this is the gusset plate, and this gusset plate is connected with the help of an angle section. So the angle section is having width of 15 millimeter. So this is known as the outstand of the gusset plate. So this is known as the outstand of the gusset plate, which is represented by S0. Now as per the codal provision and for the designing of the gusseted base, this S0 value should never be greater than 13.6 times the value of the gusset plate into epsilon, where this epsilon is equal to square root of 250 divided by Fy, where Fy is the yield strength of the plate, that is 250 megapascal. So that's why this epsilon value will come out to be as equal to 1. Now S0, that means should never be greater than 13.66 into this thickness of the gusset plate, that is provided that we have taken as 16 millimeter, into epsilon is 1. So that means from S0 we get the value that this outstand of the gusset plate, that is S0, it should always be less than equal to this value, which is coming out to be 217 millimeter. Now, this entire width was 410 millimeter. Now, out of this 410, for calculation of the outstand, that means we are calculating this portion which is extra from the column flange on both the sides. So, for calculation of the outstand, we need these two values. So, let's say this is y and this is x. This vertical distance is y and this is x. So, this x value will be calculated from 410 minus the width of the column flange. So, this width of the column flange, that is 250 millimeter. So 410 minus 250 divided by 2, that we will get as 80. So this x value is 80, while this y value that we have calculated, so that is to be calculated based upon the bolted connection. So since we were having 2 bolts, so that is 1 pitch distance and 2 of the edge distances. So from here, y that we are getting, that is the 1 into 60, that is the pitch distance, plus twice into the 39, that is the edge distances. So from here we are getting the value as 138 millimeter. So providing all the values here, so this S naught, that is the outstand of the gusset plate, that will be calculated based upon the Pythagoras theorem. So that will be the square root of 80 square plus 138 square,
and the addition of both these values.
So from here, the value of S naught that we are getting, that is equal to 159.51 millimeter, which is less than equal to 217 millimeter. So that's why all the provisions and design of sizes of the plates are in check. So that means our designing process is correct. So this is the end of this class. So we have done the problem of the gusseted base through the bolted connection. In the next class, we will see the connection of the gusseted base through weld. So thank you.